This training is among the much training undertaken by staff of the Africa Young Voices Media Empire. The training focuses on what the future holds for journalists. During the training, the managing director of AYV, Dr. Ezekiel Duramani Lako, revealed that AYV is working towards establishing a media academy to train journalists in West Africa and beyond. In the words of Lako, AYV should be the hub for media excellence in Africa.
Objective is to actually train young people around West Africa or even Africa. We want to make it a media training hub around Africa. So we're planning to invest lots of money in it. We're doing an 8-story building, guys in back and we're going to assign 2 or 3 floors of that building to this academy.
As AYV and Africa await the establishment of the AYV Media Academy, there has been constant media training for staff of AYV. This recent one is done by Nicola Phipps, an experienced media practitioner from UK. Nicola Phipps had worked with the BBC World Service, ITV, and other international media outlets. Phipps is currently a media trainer. During a presentation, she called on journalists to maintain balance and trust in the course of their work.
So those basic principles still apply, but it is now in social media first. How do we break the story effectively? But it's not just getting it first, it's getting it best, is what you need to think about. Your audience now may predominantly be on more traditional television, radio, whatever, but they won't be forever. And the more you can adapt to that, because your audience is you. And that's kind of a bit of a sad fact in this industry, because it also means we have built an obsolescence. So in 20 years' time, you need to start a channel for older people.
Staff and management thanked Phipps for sharing her experience with AYV. AYV is currently the leading media institution in Sierra Leone, and much is expected from the institution in media work. The need for regular training to meet up with the expectations cannot be overemphasized. Toloma Suma, AYV News, Freetown.